something.
And it's continued on through your childhood?
Until I was old enough to stand up for myself, yes.
You must have felt so helpless, so alone. Even then, even though you were a young man.
I didn't know that there were people out there like Dr. Michaels to reach out to for help when I was a kid. Yes, I did feel I was all alone. If I'd have known that there were people out there that were trained and ready to help, my life would have been a lot different.
Well, I'm sure that it would.
Yes.
All right, thank you, Rod. We'll be back and discuss more of the issues surrounding child abuse with Mr. Landry and my other guests after this word from our sponsors. Stay with us, please.
I'll get that.
No, that's okay. I'll see who it is.
Laura, if I were you, I would sit down and relax while I had the chance. The moment Christopher wakes up, you're going to have your hands full. Believe me.
Oh, I know that, Mrs. Hughes, but I'm actually looking forward to it.
The timing is perfect, son. They just went into a commercial. Oh, good. Hi, Graham.
Good morning,
Hi,
Laura.
Hello, Tom.
You enjoying your first day on the job?
Oh, I couldn't be happier. Would you like a cup of coffee?
Well, you read my mind. I'll get that.
Oh, thanks.
Hello. Hello? Look, I know there's somebody there. Who is this? Hello?
Must have dialed the wrong number.
The Emmy Award winner, As the World Turns. This portion brought to you today by Tartar Control Crest, the dentist's choice to help keep your teeth tartar-free, and by Attends, bladder control protection.
You okay, Rod?
Oh, thank you. Yes, yeah, I'm fine. Actually, I'm not really so fine.
Oh, you're doing fine. You look great. You could see, didn't you look handsome?
Oh, yeah, you do.
My mouth is really dry. I had no idea I'd be this nervous out here.
It doesn't show. It doesn't show.
Oh, walking up here and have seen Lucinda before I came up here before was really something that threw me. I tell you.
Don't worry about her. She's in the control room right now giving orders to some people.
It's okay.
Okay, clear the set, please.
Oh,
just
get through it.
Okay.
Yeah,
you
get through it.
Okay.
All right,
I'm trying.
Stand by. 10 seconds.
Lily and I are over here. We're rooting for you.
Nine. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three.
Welcome back. This is Patterns. You were deliberately antagonizing him, bringing up Lily's name like that? I told you, you would have to be very clever if you want to carry off this charade about the baby being his. You know, Mother, no matter what, I am still his wife, and I have a right to know where he's been all night. You mean he didn't get home at all? He told me some story about going out to the farm, and then he had a meeting, and he got home so late he didn't want to wake me up, and he slept on the couch. Come on. Emily, it is very important for you to keep Holden happy now. Read my lips. I am doing everything I can. I can't help it if he's suspicious by nature. Oh, you know something? You know what really makes me mad? Is he acts like he didn't know anything. He walked into this whole situation with his eyes wide open. I mean, he knew about James. He knew about me. He didn't have any problem taking my money now, did he? And now he acts like I tricked him. Emily, if you can't be honest with Holden, at least be honest with yourself. You did trick him.
Shh.
Into marrying you. He didn't know you were carrying James's child. Now, did he? If you told him that before the marriage, instead of dangling your trust fund like a carrot, do you have to be so blunt all the time?
Well, it's the truth.
Look, if you had been honest with Holden, maybe he would have gone for it. I don't know. I mean, a man is very sensitive about some things, like the paternity of the child that will be carrying his name. You got yourself into this, and you can get yourself out of this if you just start using your head and whatever else you have at your disposal.
And what's that mean?
Oh, we know what that means, don't we? You're a very beautiful young girl. Use it. If you don't keep Holden happy now, he's going to leave you. And everybody's going to know why.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to be such a sourpuss this morning. I didn't want to start your day off on the wrong foot.
Oh, yeah, Ed Patterson called. Do you want me to get him on the phone for you?
Yeah. Okay, but he's at Walsh. When the secretary answers the phone, say it's a personal call.
Holden. I really am so sorry. I really am. Will you forgive me, please? Please, please, please.
Okay.
I am so glad I got here in time to see most of Kim's show.
Well, they just went into a commercial break.
Oh, well, great. That gives me time to make a little phone call. Would you prefer I use your phone?
No, no, go ahead and use this one, but be extremely quiet. You know, it is impossible to watch television uninterrupted in this house. You see what I mean? I noticed that.
I'll take care of him.
Oh, that's okay, Laura.
Oh, hello. May I speak with Beau Farrell, please? Oh, hi, Beau. Look, this is Lisa Mitchell. I just got a phone call from one of our waiters at Mona Lisa. He's sick, and I need you to take over for him tonight, if you could.
Sure, no problem.
Great. Oh, by the way, the carpenters are working downstairs, and they're just making a wonderful progress down there. And as soon as they finish the cellar, you'll be able to just sing your heart out.
That sounds good. I'm still around.
What do you mean if you're still around? You better be. Look, everybody is asking for you now that you made your big debut. I'll see you tonight around 5 at Mona Lisa.
Okay. Yeah, I will do. Thanks.
Okay, Ryan, you've got about 30 minutes before work detail. You want to go back to your cell as usual?
No, I'd like to stay here if that's all right. Thanks. It's a bit racy for Jennersville. Hi. I haven't seen you around for a while. How's it going? Been kind of busy.
Yeah, haven't we all?
Hal came to see me again. Brought Paul with him this time.
But I thought you said you didn't want Paul to see you in here.
Well, that's what I thought until I saw him. Just seeing his old face. Well, it made me feel very optimistic.
That's good. But, be careful, all right? Sometimes the higher you get your hopes up in here, the lower you sink when you realize you still have a prison term to serve. I've seen it happen.
Yeah, I'm sure. But I'm determined to be optimistic. Sal's told me that he's working day and night to find new evidence to clear me.
Barbara, look, if there was something that could clear you, don't you think Hal would have found it before you were sentenced? I mean, the guy who killed your ex-husband managed to cover his tracks all throughout the investigation and stood by and watched while you were convicted. I mean, right now, he's pleased as punch that you're in here instead of him. And he's probably gonna be damn certain that he continues to cover his tracks, too.
Yeah, well, I only know one or two people that could be. The other suspects happen to be my friends.
You know, one thing I've learned in here is that when it comes to saving your own skin, friendship doesn't count for a whole lot. Look, I don't mean to sound hard-hearted about this or anything, but it's helpful to face reality in here, Barbara. You're going to be here for 6 years, probably. And the sooner you accept that, it's like this design you're doing. By the time you get out of here, this is going to be long out of style. Hey, I'm going to bum a cigarette from Nolan. You want one?
Slam and Pammy, what's happening?
Oh, Mrs. O'Connell in room 305 wouldn't let me take her temperature. She said she wanted a real nurse. Laugh.
Well, us lowly residents get the same abuse around here, believe me.
Oh, so when are you going to be a real doctor?
April, and I'm counting the days.
Well, I will see you. I will.
Excuse me. Okay.
And you give my love to Bryant, okay? All right, then. Casey wants to speak to you. Okay, bye-bye.
I see. Just wanted to say, keep calling. It makes my life a lot easier around here, you know what I mean? How are you doing?
How is she?
Well, we miss you, too.
Well, she seems very happy, and she's very excited.
When are you coming back?
Things have turned around in Montego, so she has decided to stay.
Well, in the meantime, take care of that little rat. We miss him, okay?
I don't want to be the one to tell Aunt Lucinda that.
Okay, all right.
You're not too partial to the idea, too, are you? Well, I'm not exactly enthusiastic about it. Although she seems very positive about things in Montego. I mean, honestly, I see how. Yeah. I guess I'm just born to worry. I don't know.
Well, you said it. I didn't.
Oh, you're kidding.
Oh, well, hello. Hey. Nice to see you. Lila, I have a 9:45 appointment with John.
Oh, he just called down, and he's late in an appointment with Rex, but he'll be right down to see you.
Thank you.
Have you talked to Meg in Rome?
Yes, as a matter of fact, she called last night. She's going to be here in Oakdale today.
Oh, great.
Isn't that wonderful?
Know that. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm so excited.
Hey, Dusty, where is Lily? Does she have classes today?
No. As a matter of fact, Lily is at the television station, you know, because Rod's going to be on Kim's show today. So Lily went there.
I forgot all about that. You know, we could probably catch half of it if there were...
Well, there's a television in the lounge.
Yeah,
Lila will be in the lounge
here.
Oh,
John.
Okay.
Fine.
So, is Bo still down at the stables, or...?
No, he found a room downtown at the boarding house. I had dinner with him last night there.
Oh, that's nice. So does that mean that he's going to be getting on his way pretty soon?
No, it doesn't look like it. Lisa Mitchell offered him a job at Mona Lisa's, and as soon as she opens the room downstairs, he's going to be singing there a couple nights, which is great for the kids at the university.
Let me ask you something. Why would he even consider accepting that offer from Lisa if he wanted to get back to L.A. so quickly?
Well, maybe he doesn't want to get back so quickly.
Okay. All right. It's time for my break. Is it time for your break?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Why don't we go down and get a cup of coffee? Do you want to do that?
Yeah.
Okay. What are you
doing? It's nice that I can accept to have a cup of coffee with you and not want anything more than that. It just feels good. Maybe you and I will become friends. Maybe.
Maybe. Okay, fine. You just...
Well, let's see. Sierra's happy in Montego. Margo's happy with Tom. So I guess that means you're gonna have to devote all of your time to me.
Ow!
Guess I spoke too soon. What's the problem?
It's just every time Sierra calls, the first question that she always asks is, have you heard any news about Craig?
Hmm?
I just wish I had enough faith as she does that he's coming back.
Antonio, look, we're finally over the land.
Rome has been absolutely wonderful, but I'll tell you, I think it's going to be more fun going back and telling everybody about it. I have a diary up, like, written down every single thing that we've done.
What are those?
Now, these are custom forms. We have to declare everything we bought while we were in Rome and pay duty on them when we land in Chicago.
Well, I hope I didn't forget anybody.
Well, judging by this list of presents, I don't think we did.
That's good. Well, Frank, it was so sweet to send this to my hotel room. And the shoes he gave me. Oh, my Lord. They must have cost a fortune. You know, Tonio, everything was going so wonderfully. I don't know. A part of me is just really afraid it won't stay that way. I mean, I'm just so afraid everything's going to change.
Nothing's going to happen, Meg. Don't worry.
These films, which were smuggled out of the country, show the deplorable conditions under which many hostages are living. You can see the look of quiet desperation in their eyes. Once you see, you're completely cut off from contact with the outside world and your loved ones back home.
Well, I guess I should watch you fill those out so we... What did you do? What did you write here?
What?
Craig. You see that right here? Why did you write Craig on that form?
I'll have to see the stewardess and try and get another form. I'll be right back. That's all I can tell you now. No. Look, there's no need for you to know where I am. I don't know when I'll be back. However long it takes me to do what I have to do. Yeah, well, trouble's not new to me. Look, it's a new town. Maybe I'll get lucky, be able to put it all behind me. No, I don't want you to tell anybody I called. If I need help, I'll ask for it. Look, I gotta go. Yeah, I will. Bye. Hi, it's one of your neighbors. I just moved in across the hall. Can I talk to you a minute?
About what?
About some of the rules of the building. Well, just take a second. Hi, I'm Beau Farrell.
Hello, I'm Janet Lazarus.
It's nice to meet you, Janet. Look, do you mind if we talk inside? If the landlady sees me standing here, she'll think I'm making a pest of myself.
Well, all right, I guess it'd be okay. Yeah. Come on in.
I don't understand how anybody could abuse a helpless child.
Me neither.
Well, we've been seeing both Dr. Michaels and a family counselor for, a little over a year, ever since the children were taken away from us. They're in foster care homes now, until the authorities decide that Catherine's well enough for them to live with us again.
It's not just the children who've had to pay the price for what I did. Donald has too. I was the one with the problem. I was the one who abused them. He never laid a hand on those children.
Well, that may be so, Mrs. West, but all the same, your husband is just as responsible as you are. I mean, he saw it happen, and he didn't do anything about it.
I understand that you have very strong feelings about this, but, you know, your situation is one thing, and the Wests have their own experience.
It's all the same thing. My mother was silent, just like you were. She knew what was going on. She heard my stepfather. She heard him hit me, heard me screaming. She never did anything about it. Now, in my book, this makes her just as guilty as he was. You have to accept your guilt, Mr. West.
You're absolutely right, Mr. Landry.
No.
I do have to share the responsibility for what happened.
That's one of the things that Dr. Michaels is helping me come to terms with in my therapy. And it's not easy.
Mrs. West, you were starting to explain to us that you yourself were an abused child.
Yes, by my father. But I didn't know where to go for help or even that help was available. So I ran away from home when I was 14, and I was so ashamed by what I'd been through that I didn't tell anyone. I never dealt with the anger that was inside me, and so it just festered and grew. And then when Donald and I were married and had children of our own, I didn't know what a normal parent-child relationship was, so I found that I was treating my children the same way my father had treated me.
Now, Well, then this is something that we haven't discussed yet, the fact that abused children often become abusive parents.
I don't think that's always so. I don't think that's true.
Well, it's not always so, of course not, but studies show that...
I don't care what studies show. I have a daughter of my own. I would never harm my daughter or any other child.
All we're saying is that when children grow up abused, they have a lot of suppressed anger.
I know all about this anger. I grew up with this anger. The anger got inside of me to a point where it exploded, and I raped my own cousin. I know that... But I would never harm another child. I don't know. I can't be here anymore.
Well, this is awful.
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you today by Era Plus, protein power to cut clean through, and by Mr. Clean. Dries virtually streak-free, so your floors look shiny wet, even when dry. We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment. And now, part two of As the World Turns.
Oh, Lord. That was really terrible what happened.
He just became so nervous. I mean, the minute he walked on, and then I guess it just was too much for him.
Yeah, well, I guess you really got to have your trip together if you're going to get on camera and talk about personal stuff.
Well, I guess you have to respect him for that.
Hey, Lila. Did you see Ken's show? Rod Landry made a total fool of himself.
No, Susan, I didn't see that.
That was amazing. Have you seen John around? I have to talk to him.
Well, he's still in a meeting with Rex, and as soon as he gets out, he has an appointment with Emma Snyder.
Oh.
Hello.
Hi. Hello.
Hi.
See you. Thank you. I guess you just saw your cousin make a public humiliation of himself. Can't say that I'd feel sorry for him. How dare he go on a show like that and pretend to be some paragon of virtue? I wish Holden or somebody would talk to Betsy.
Susan, you know, it must have been very hard for him to go on that show. I think he only did it because he was trying to help other people.
And some people should be concerned about their own problems before they start criticizing others.
What? Okay, fine. Well, I think that was pretty nice, huh? I mean, you and I having coffee again, like friends.
Listen, I wanted to ask you a question.
What?
You've asked me out to the carriage house a couple times. Now, over the holidays, and I always say no.
Yes.
Well, maybe I'll bring Beau out there. I mean, I think it'll be nice for him to meet some people. What?
Ma'am, he's brand new around here. You have
Dusty,
to be careful.
Dusty,
you meet
Dusty,
someone new,
we were having
meet...
a really great time, okay? I'd appreciate it if you would just...
Bonjour!
Spanish?
That's all I know.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey. Wonderful. Europe agrees with you.
Oh, thank you very much.
Nice.
Beautiful.
Oh, gosh, I practically slept on these clothes in the plane. I must look hideous. I got presents for everybody. Let's see, one for you, one for
really?
You, one for you. Yes.
So I'm going to get your company back on top by spring. I thought you might like to hear that, Monica. Oh, well, why don't we discuss it over lunch? Okay, good. I'll pick you up about 12:30. No, I made a point in not watching it. I'm not surprised to hear that. Okay, see you soon.
Yeah, surprised to hear what?
Good old Josh, he made a jerk of himself on Kim's TV show. He ended up walking off the set right in the middle of the show.
Betsy was at the studio. She's probably so upset.
Yeah, maybe it's good for her. It gives her a first-hand experience of what Josh is really like.
No. Betsy has a lot of feelings for Rod. I mean, after everything that's happened with Steve, I don't think it's... I just don't want to see her hurt again.
Well, then tell her to get Josh out of her life and Danny's life before something serious happens.
Hello, everybody.
How are you?
How are you doing?
Welcome home.
Thank you, Emily. A token of appreciation from Franco Visconti.
A present for Emily? Oh.
So how did it go? Things went very well, but I'll fill you in later.
Wow, this is beautiful.
Tony, I don't even know this guy. Why would he send this to me?
Well, you will soon enough. He's coming to Oakdale in about a month, and I told him what a wonderful addition you were to the office, and he's very interested in meeting you.
Well, isn't that sweet? I don't know what to say. It's beautiful.
How about thanks, but no thanks? You better just send it right back to him, because when he gets here, he might want to collect.
Oh, you party pooper, stop it. He's not like that, is he?
Not at all. Franco enjoys the company of beautiful women, but what healthy man doesn't? He was very charming to Meg.
I bet.
And I didn't mind in the least.
Well, that's your way, Tonio, but if Franco Visconti comes here and he starts putting the moves on my wife, he's going to have to deal with me in another way besides business. You may be into his continental morals, but I'm not.
Holden, you're going to have to try and change your provincial way of thinking. But enough of that. Why don't you bring me up to speed on what's going on here?
First, I think you just better call Hal Munson, because he wanted to talk to you when you got back, remember? I'll wait for you out here.
Well, Emily, I hope you don't return the gift. I think Franco would be offended.
No. I'm not going to return it.
Good.
You know, you gave Barbara a beautiful handbag when she visited his factory in Rome. So much has changed since then. Just to think about it makes me feel so...
Feel so what?
Sad. How else would I feel?
Sure, I remember Tonio Reyes from when I was modeling with you. You and him were pretty hot and heavy for a while.
Getting involved with that man was the second biggest mistake of my life. Getting involved with James Stenbeck was the first. And now I'm paying for them both.
I take it you two didn't part as friends.
Hardly. In fact, he's single-handedly responsible for me being in here.
What, you mean he testified against you?
He lied through his teeth.
Just goes to show you can't trust anybody. Not even somebody you were close to once.
I made a lot of mistakes with men.
Well, haven't we all? Kind of makes you want to give up on them after a while, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, I kind of did. Until Hal came along. He made me trust again. He was very understanding, very kind. I'm sorry.
Hey, no sweat. I have a lot of good memories of Hal. But that's all they are now, memories. What he and I had ended the day that I came up here. And I decided to forget about him rather than torturing myself, thinking and wondering about what might have been. And if you want to save yourself a lot of heartache, you'll do the same thing, because sooner or later, he's going to meet someone else.
That's what I told him. But he's determined to wait for me. In fact, he bought my apartment. He sees Paul every day.
Barbara, you have only been in here a few weeks. Come on. I mean, I'm not saying that Hal isn't sincere or anything. I'm sure he is. But 6 years? It's a long time for anyone to wait, even if they're in love.
Yo, Denise. Hey, Celeste, it's simply Barbara Ryan, the famous designer. She must be some tough lady to have shot that sleazeback Stenbeck.
Ah, come on, Martha. Everybody knows you don't need guts to shoot a guy in the back. Even if you do it twice. What do you say we see just how tough she is?
I know Rod was upset, but why did he leave the TV studio like that? He's just going to make it harder for himself.
Well, I know, but that's what he does, Lily. He acts first and he thinks later.
You've gotten very close with him, haven't you? I'm trying to get closer to him. I'm trying to develop some kind of relationship we can both be comfortable with. But I have such a... sometimes it's very hard to get over the fact that... What he did die for.
I know. I feel exactly the same way, believe me.
Could you ever get past it enough to maybe...
I honestly don't know. I've thought about it 1,000 times, and every time I come up with a different answer.
Well,
The security guard said that Rod left the studio after he ran off the set.
Oh, I was afraid of that.
We had a session scheduled for right after the show. I hope he's on his way to Memorial. I don't know.
Dr. Michaels, can I come with you, please?
Oh.
I'd really like to see if he's there.
Sure, Lily. Yeah.
Do you want to come?
I don't know. I think I'm going to make some phone calls. I'll call over to the construction site. Maybe he went to work. Maybe he's at his apartment.
Honey, why don't you make the calls from our house? Then if you want, you can stay for lunch.
Okay.
And I'll call you if I see hear anything or see him at the hospital.
Yeah, I'll get back to you if I can reach him.
Mrs. Hughes.
Yes, darling.
What did Lucinda say about all this?
Well, let's just say that she wasn't too pleased. She pointed out that she had insisted that Rod couldn't be trusted.
Well, Mom, before you leave, I need to ask you a favor.
For you, Thomas Christopher Hughes, the sky's the limit.
Okay, well, the weatherman is calling for snow this evening, so Margot and I thought we'd spend a nice little quiet, romantic evening at home.
I believe the operative word there is romantic. Hmm?
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, since neither of us are what you would call skilled in the kitchen, I was wondering if maybe
you just say no more. I'll have the chef at Mona Lisa fix up a most scrumptious meal for two. He will include fantastic wine, candles, and flowers, and have it delivered to your cottage.
Perfect. Mom, you're the best.
Well, don't you forget it. I know I'm the best.
I want you to understand that I would be pampering Earl if he were here, but of course he's busy taking care of all kinds of things in Europe. So in the meantime, I'm just going to have to cater to you and Margot.
Oh, that sounds all right.
Laura, do you know where is Bob?
He's up in the nursery with Tom and Chris's grandmother. He said my services aren't required till he leaves for the hospital. I'm starting to feel a little unneeded here.
don't you worry. You're going to be plenty busy. Well, I'm going to go find Bob. I want to say goodbye before I go off to fashion.
Bye, sweetheart.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Your family is something else.
Yeah, well, we're not as crazy as we seem. We're probably a lot crazier.
Oh, I don't think you're crazy at all. You and your mother are so close. And even though she and Dr. Hughes are divorced, she's so friendly with him and Kim. It's just so nice being around a family that's supportive.
You know, you're so right, and I think sometimes I may just take that for granted.
You shouldn't, Tom. You're very, very lucky.
What's your family like?
There was just me and my little brother, Billy, so it's a lot different. But I was always close with my parents. I still am, since they're taking care of Jennifer and Darren for me. Well, they've just been terrific.
It must be so difficult being separated from your kids like that.
It is. But I know that as soon as I put a little money aside and save for a bigger apartment, that they'll be with me again. I just have to keep holding on to that thought, and it will make all of what I'm going through seem worth it.
You know, I think Dad was right.
About what?
Well, he said from the moment he met you, he knew you were a very special woman. Now, I know through talking to you some of the problems you had with your ex-husband, but he must have been certifiable to let you walk out of that house with those kids.
Thank you. But I didn't walk away from Victor. I ran for my life and for the safety of my children.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to dredge up any painful memories.
Well, I'm headed back to the hospital, Laura. I'll leave Christopher in your capable hands.
Okay.
Kim should be home fairly soon, and if you need me for anything, call me at the hospital.
Okay.
If you can't reach Dad, give me a call at the DA's office, and all my knowledge of children would probably fit on the head of a pin, but I'll be glad to willingly give you any advice.
I've never felt so well protected in my life.
Great.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Hughes residence. Hello. What are you doing here?
Pam. I hate to keep laying all my personal problems on you, but you're the only friend I've got here.
What happened?
I got kicked out of my new room at the boarding house.
Why?
The landlady said I was playing my nylon string guitar too loud at night.
Well, that's ridiculous. She knew you were a musician when you moved in there.
Yeah, but...
God, first you get mugged and then you get thrown out of your apartment. Did that old bag give you your money back? We're going to go down there right now and get your rent back.
Pam, no.
Why?
Look,
Lisa, look, it's awfully sweet of you to want to come up, but it's a long drive, and Hal and Paul are coming up already.
Well, then I'll just have to take a ticket and stand in line. Hopefully, I can talk Kent into coming with me. No, wait. Please, I will not have you try to discourage me. I am coming up to see you tomorrow, and that is that.
Thanks. Thanks, you're a good friend.
Well, I always will be. Now tell me something, Barbara. Is there anything you want from home?
Sure, my silk robe, my warm, fuzzy bedroom slippers, and my perfume. That would be very nice, but I don't think the management would take too kindly to it. But really, all I want to see is your face. It'd be nice to have a woman to talk to.
Well, I should certainly think you've had your fill of that by now.
Well, believe me, most of the women around here you wouldn't want to be in the same room with, let alone talk to. Two of them tried to start a fight with me earlier.
Barbara, for heaven's sake.
I know. But fortunately, Denise was here, and she stopped it. If she hadn't been...
Look, I thought the guards were supposed to prevent anything like that from happening.
Yeah. Yeah, well, they can't be everywhere. And all it takes is a split second for something to happen.
Barbara, please. Oh, please, you be careful.
I will. I don't want you to worry, okay? I've got to get off the phone. They time our calls.
All right, I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, Aletha, have you talked to Lucinda or Emily?
No, why? Haven't you heard from them? Well, I guess they're just afraid to show their face.
I really do have to go now, okay? And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Time to get back to work, Ryan.
Yeah, well, thanks for letting me make the call, okay?
Look, take some more free time. I'll come back and pick you up in about 20 minutes.
Good, thanks.
Where's your bodyguard, Ryan? Looks like we finally get the chance to meet the famous Simply Barbara without Denise here to spoil our fun.
Well, I guess you heard the news. Your father blew it today.
I don't want to hear it, Holden. I was there.
Just tell me one thing. How can you forgive him and not forgive me?
Rod never lied to me. You did.
You know, I am sick and tired of hearing that. You are such a hypocrite. You've been lying to yourself all this time, just like you've been lying to me.
Dusty, you have got completely the wrong idea of what was going on. He was just upset because he got thrown out of his apartment building.
And where's he planning on living now, Pam?
The stables. He's on his way there now.
Well, this is sort of a belated wedding present for Holden and Emily, and I'm hoping that you and your family will come.
Well, Susan, I really don't think we can make it that night. I know that we have a...
I'll be back soon.
Oh, Laura, your job description does not include grocery shopping.
From what I understand, my job is to make your life easier. And if that means going to the store every now and then, I'm happy to. Besides, it's beautiful out.
Yeah, it is, but it's so cold. But you're going to make yourself indispensable.
Oh, it's nice to feel needed again.
Well, when you come back, we'll have lunch, and that way you can get to know Betsy better.
Oh, thanks, I'd like that. See you soon.